In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now, Lord, be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, increase our faith and hope and charity, and make us love what you command. So God, that we may merit what you promise, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians and to us. Brothers and sisters, as long as in every way, whether in pretense or in truth, Christ is being proclaimed, and in that I rejoice. Indeed, I shall continue to rejoice, for I know that this will result in deliverance for me. Through your prayers and support from the Spirit of Jesus Christ. My eager expectation and hope is that I shall not be put to shame in any way, but that with all boldness, now as always, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. And this I know with confidence, that I shall remain and continue in the service of all of you for your progress and joy in the faith, so that your boasting in Christ Jesus may abound on account of me when I come to you again. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm is, My soul is thirsting for the living God.
My soul is thirsting for the living God.
As the hind longs for the running waters, so my soul longs for you, O God.
My soul is thirsting for the living God.
A thirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? I went with the throng and led them in procession to the house of God. Amid loud cries of joy and thanksgiving, with the multitude keeping festival.
My soul is thirsty.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. Alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia. The Lord be with you. I read it from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you,
Lord. On a Sabbath, Jesus went to dine at the home of one of the leading Pharisees, and the people there were observing him carefully. He told a parable to those who had been invited, noticing how they were choosing the places of honor at the table. When you are are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not recline at the table in the place of honor. A more distinguished guest than you may have been invited by him, and the host who invited both of you may approach you and say, "Give your place to this man," and then you would proceed with embarrassment to take the lowest place. Rather, when you are invited, go and take the lowest place. So then, when the host comes to you, he may say, "My friend, move up to a higher position." Then you will enjoy the esteem of your companions at the table. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, but the one who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. St. Paul is writing to the Philippians from a prison, and yet he is full of joy for the community and its growth and faith, and is detached from any worry about his own faith. St. Paul's detachment from worldly concerns and humility in the service of the gospel are great examples for us. And now, brothers and sisters, let us offer our intentions to God, our Heavenly Father, for Pope Francis and all our bishops. May they be sanctified by the gift of the Holy Spirit for the good of the world. Let us pray to the Lord. For government officials, may they be filled with God's wisdom as they respond to the needs of the poor in their countries and communities. Let us pray to the Lord. For all members of our faith community, may the Lord increase our charity and commitment to the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, especially Teresa Delfine Bello, Asuncio Maximo Castro, for whom this mass is offered, may the Lord shine his face upon them and give them eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Ever living and gracious Father, we humbly pray that you hear and answer the petitions we place before you today. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O God of creation, for the goodness you have seen the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands, you will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, O God of creation, for the goodness we have seen the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and will become our spiritual being. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, we pray, Lord, that the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is a child of the
Christ our Lord, his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with hope, and so with all the angels and saints we praise, as about them we are glad.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed the Holy Lord, the Father of all holiness, the main glory, and therefore these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion and his bread, and giving the thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, to say, take this, all of you, and eat up it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving the thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have heard us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body God of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with France of Pope and Grace of Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Zach, and all the saints that please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced in eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and I am you of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, be the angel and be the giver, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the will, who live and reign forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world.
The Lord and our God, behold the hem who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those born to the sop of the land.
Lord, I am not
thank you. I believe.